Hello, this is just a short video to review some concepts that you probably are comfortable with. Continuously compounded interest, which is an exponential function, pretty familiar to all of us. The formula A is equal to PE to the RT power is our continuously compounded function. A is the amount of money that we end up with. P is our principal amount of money. E is our exponential function, which is approximately the value, right, 2.7. R is the rate that we will be talking about in the problem, and T is the amount of time in years. So this is a problem from our textbook. How long will it take a $500 investment to be worth $700 if it is continuously compounded at 10% per year? So if you look at the little spreadsheet that I've set up here, I certainly want to have a cell for time and a cell for money. The time, these inputs are simply time in years, and I just set up a reasonable domain from 0 to 5 years. In the first cell under money, that's where I'm going to type in my formula. So my formula is my principal amount, $500, times my exponential function raised to the 0.1 times G7 cell, which is that cell access for that independent variable of time. For those of you who are struggling a little bit with how to enter that, remember, you type your equal sign, 500, times, you start typing exp, you can either double-click that function and your parentheses appear, and in the parentheses, you simply type what you want to go on in the exponent. Well, you know that in this formula, R times T is the exponent. The rate here, remember, even though it shows up as a percentage, to use it in a formula or function, it has to be a decimal. So 10% as a decimal is 0.1 times our time. Well, if I knew the value of time, let me try 3 years just to give you an idea. If I knew that it was 3 years had passed, I could enter the 3, hit enter, and look, that's the same amount of money that I have up here at 3 years. But because I didn't know the time, if I had just used a cell reference of the cell next door to it, notice in the cell here, there's nothing there, so it would be a 0. And if I enter that, it's going to give me my initial amount of money. Because isn't it true that anything raised to the 0 power is 1? So our principal amount of 500 multiplied by 1 is 500. All right, that's a quick little review of this. But now what you can see is I've double-clicked that down, and I've gotten some values. To answer the question, it says, how long will it take? So I'm looking for how many years. If I know the output, but I don't know the input, then we know that that's got to be a goal-seek problem. So it looks to me like sometime between 3 and 4 years, I'm going to hit that magic number of 700. But let's go ahead and goal-seek down here in the last cell. So I'm going to click on the last cell that I have there, data, what if, goal-seek. I'm going to goal seek to 700. The cell that I'm going to change is the input cell. That says that the account should reach approximately $700 in 3.365 years. So just, you know, a month or two into the third year. So that's my first example. Let me get rid of this orange text box here, move it aside, and let's focus on the other problem now. We're going to keep this formula, but what we want to think about now is I have another question about investments, but this one's a little bit different. It says, how long to the nearest year will it take an investment to triple if it is continuously compounded at 10% per year? So these are always interesting questions because sometimes people get a little bit unnerved if I don't give you that principal amount that I'm beginning with. Well, interestingly enough, it doesn't matter, and I'll show you that in just a second. But what we're looking at is, again, here's my time, and I've put in some values that represent time in years. Here's my money, and you'll be able to see that what I've done is I have essentially created my formula based on just the ERT part of my PERT function, okay? Because I want you to think about this a little bit. If my original amount had been, say, $500, the tripling of $500 would be $1,500, right? But if I divided off that $500 from the formula, it would just be a 1 there. So I'm going to do it like this to show you, and then we'll always end up with the same result, even if we do it another way. But there's my formula. I don't have to worry about typing in a value for principal. It's essentially just a 1 there. So when I enter that, you basically drag that down. Okay, so the question is saying, when does, or how long does it take the investment to triple? So basically, if my initial amount of money was $1, I'm basically trying to figure out, well, when would it be $3? I'm going to go down to the bottom, and again, I'm going to hit data, what if, goal seek, and the value that I'm looking for now, tripling, would be $3. The cell that I'm going to change is this cell. So you can see from this, it looks like we would have our money tripled in 10.99 years, almost 11 years. I'm going to click OK, and then I want to show you something a little bit different. Suppose in the money, my original amount is, let's say, $400. Okay, I'm going to wrap that text. Okay, so we're going to think about if my original amount is $400, how this problem would look a little bit different. So I would type in now, I would say is equal to 400 times my exponential function. Again, my interest rate, 0.1, times the cell that I'm accessing, I still come back over here. Close my parentheses and hit enter. And that basically says at time zero, no time has passed, my money is 400. Well, now let's double click it down. All right. So you can see that these values are very different than the values that I had initially. But if I go to the bottom, notice that if I'm comparing 400 and 1200, certainly 1200 is 3 times my original amount. But suppose I didn't know this middle column, right? And I went down and this was a different value. So let's just type in, let's go back to 20. That's what I had originally. Now let's goal seek. But we're not going to goal seek to 3. We would be goal seeking to the tripled value of 400, which would be 1200. The cell that we're going to change, again, is our time value. And there you see the number come right back into play. That's primarily what we do with exponential functions in Excel in this early unit. Hope that helps.